now, Mapco Market. So then you would get blueberries. Shah, if we buy it, we are not going to get it from, like, you know, tomorrow, one day delivery and stuff like that. Oof, I really hope rights have blue today with them. Otherwise, it's not going to be Earth ice cream. Then I message, okay, suggest what color would you want your planet to be then, if not blue?
Oh, white ice cream with green.
Only green, along with green, which other color? So, it was a riot in the group yesterday. Yes, Puneet, we were saying something. No? Okay, let's get started. So, what I'm going to do is, I'll give you a paragraph to read, and of course, I'll ask questions based on that. And before we go ahead with that, we'll start with the debate. Okay, do you want me to keep the debate towards the end of the class or towards, like, right now, starting?
Starting.
Right now? Okay, so we'll start with the debate and then further we'll move on to the passage. The second passage, or you want to do the second passage
second
first?
Second
passage first. And then we'll move on to debate.
Yeah.
How many agree with Safiya? Raise your hand. So you have two options. First, we start with the debate and then we do the second passage. The second option is we do the second passage first and then do the debate. Safiya says we'll do the second passage first.
Yes, ma'am. Second passage first.
Because we'll finish it fast now.
Right, we'll finish it fast.
Oh, we're smart, huh? Smarty pants.
Okay, let's go. So you have to start reading from here. I walked alone the streets of Delhi till the end. And it's just four lines left after that. If you finish reading this.
Man, that four lines will not read. Ma'am, can you scroll down?
Yeah, sure. Let me get one more person and then I'll scroll down.
Ma'am, please scroll it down.
Hello, ma'am, wait.
Ma'am, we did not read it.
From last paragraph.
Above that also, ma'am. Above that also. Yeah, that's enough.
Ma'am, finish.
Finish. Safiya, make me the host.
I thought you were the host.
Give me the power.
Sorry. Sorry.
bed.
Why you did that with Isabia?
All I was about to click your video, but it got that.
It got what?
You think?
Scroll. Ma'am, please scroll.
Ma'am, please
scroll. Debate time.
Kinshana. We'll try finishing this off by 10:20, and then from 10:20 we'll have a debate. By the way, you always have to repeat your speeches. Because I don't know about you guys, I have forgotten all the points that you mentioned. Zalo?
Ma'am, scroll down, please.
Yes, that's it. It's the end of the story. The group dispersed and I went home with Shavanlal that night. Is the end of the story.
Okay, then. Done.
Done.
Yes.
Oh my god. All right. Let's see if you can answer these. All right, first question for you. Why did Shavanlal initially show his reluctance? Reluctance means not agreeing to accept the young man's proposal. You know who Shavanlal, right? Who's Shavanlal over here?
The shoe shine.
And who's the young man over here?
Alright, author.
The narrator. All right, yeah. So why did Shavanlal initially show reluctance?
Can I say?
Accept. No. This class, Moni will not answer any questions.
No, I will be not in the debate also.
No, yeah. No. You have to be in the debate. Yeah, I will not be in this question. Anya, you can do that.
Yeah, this is cheating, ma'am.
No.
Ma'am, because he was thinking that would his friends in his union let him work there as a sushi.
Is that the initial...
Ma'am, you were thinking that the young man is making fun of him.
No, ma'am.
And, okay, so in between young man making fun and Shavanlal worrying about other friends accepting him in the union, in between that there was something that Shavanlal was wondering, therefore he showed reluctance. I like how Musfira enters.
Can I say?
No. Anybody else? Marana has gone. Farana set. The sun sets, Farana set. Oh, Farana rose. Yes, Munib, go ahead.
Ma'am, because his, many of the people of that Shushine Union did not...
That's what Mudabbir said. In before that, what Mudabbir said is the right answer, by the way. Okay, but that's just the second half of the answer. I want the first half of the answer.
When the narrator was very nervous.
Okay, Mazam's point. Let me just take that point ahead, and you will come to it. Mazam said that Shavanlal thought the narrator is making fun of him by saying that even by volunteering to work as a shoeshine. Why would Shavanlal think that he's making fun?
Because he was educated.
Yes, very good. Because he was educated and, oh my God, I'm so sorry. But that was Juveria at the back? That was Juveria or Zainab? For a minute, I thought that's Anita. I don't know why, but the hair just reminded me of Anita. I was like, what is she doing at Sophia's place? Oh, God.
I am half asleep. So you
and both of them cut their hair in cut.
Yeah, okay, they got haircut, fine. Alright. So you see, Shravan Lal thought that he is already an educated man. So what is the purpose? Like what is the need for him to work as a shoeshine? That's the reason he was a little reluctant. And then second thought that came to his mind was what Mudabbir said. He was also worried whether the union will let him work.
Ma'am, the Shravan Lal's passage will come in the exam.
It's only snake bites.
Ma'am, you could say snake bite is not coming.
Achha?
Speaking ke liye na.
Only speaking is not there, but you have to.
So writing you have to do from snake bite.
Snake bite only. You only have to prepare for snake bite. It's just a 20 mark test. What more do you want? Okay, why was polishing shoes on the pavement treated like begging?
Because it was illegal.
Yeah?
Because it was illegal.
Because it was illegal.
Because usually poor people do that.
No.
Illegal means illegal.
Yes. Farhana is close to the answer because it was found to be illegal. Like they have unions and they are given places. Okay, so these unions assign them places, areas where they can do their shoe shine. But if they move out of that place and
they will punish them.
No, that's if they move, yes, it is punishable. But if they move out of that place and they go around, like, you know, randomly walking and approaching strangers for shoe shining, it's just like beggars, how beggars approach randomly. They walk everywhere and they ask, they beg people. So that's the reason it was considered illegal. Yes. Or it was treated like begging. What trouble was the Shoeshine Union having with the authorities? What trouble did the union have with the authorities? There was something that the union wanted to convey to the authorities. But that correspondence could not take place. Why
that
do you think
we,
that?
They used to get more money than the people.
No. Yes, Farhana.
It was because the person didn't know how to speak English.
Yes, it is because the people of union did not know how to speak English. They needed somebody, some English speaking. Yes.
No, ma'am. They knew
they need education.
English, but not like not exactly English, but somewhat like that.
No, so the authorities of the union, they wanted to convey a message to the people, okay? And the message is always given, usually it's spoken and given in written. So the written stuff was in English, okay? The authorities don't speak each and every instruction while they are telling you. All the detailed instructions and messages written in the application form. They needed somebody who speaks English so that the person can correspond, read and write to the authorities whatever their demands are. Understood? So that is how the communication couldn't take place. Therefore, they needed somebody who speaks English.
Yeah.
How did Shravan Lal and his friends help the author?
Polishing his shoes.
Really? I have no idea. I thought the author did not want to get his shoes polished.
Ma'am, can I say?
Yes, Munir.
Bye. Can
ma'am,
I say?
Because, ma'am, they helped him by buying that shoe shine box in 7 rupees.
They helped him buy the shoe shine box in 7 rupees?
No,
they started collecting money.
They collected money. So whatever savings they had for themselves, they collected, they put it in a box and they gave it to the author saying that tomorrow if you add a little, you'll be able to buy a set for yourself. Okay, and then maybe you can start the shoe shine.
And they even helped him, encourage him.
Yes, they encouraged him by giving him their savings, okay, by helping.
Next question.
By sharing money.
No, okay. To Shravan Lal.
Shravan Lal?
No, they helped him by like encouraging him that you come with us. Like,
no, that they wanted his help.
Ma'am, I didn't understand this question. What quality of
Shravan Lal? What quality of Shravan Lal's character is evident in his efforts? Okay, what efforts are we talking about here?
That's the shoe shine.
He persuaded his friends
to
let
the author in.
And he also persuaded the author to get his shoes polished.
He did not persuade the author. The author actually persuaded Shravan Lal to let him into the shoe shine business.
No,
okay. Shravan Lal was reluctant. He was like, no, Babu, you do not work because you're educated.
No, ma'am. In serial starting of Shravan Lal.
For getting the shoe shine. Okay.
Shoe.
So we are not talking about the starting. This is passage 2. And these answers are related to from where you've read. Okay.
Evident.
So keep it in mind the passage that you just read. What qualities of Shravan Lal is evident in his efforts.
He kept silent when his friends were.
He was helpful.
He was helpful.
He was helpful.
The answer. Very good, Amina. He was helpful. Okay. And that's it. He was helpful.
He is to listen to each and everyone, not like one person speak. But
I mean, he was not only helpful, he also acted as a mediator. Okay, so between the author, mediator, somebody who, like, you know, takes the message from one place to another. Like, a mediator is a person who will try to balance things, try to balance things on both the sides. All right,
okay.
So, like, on one side, he had the author who wanted the job, and other side, he had the union where there was no extra place for somebody new to come in, but still, somehow, he convinced them as well. And he helped the author as well. So he played a role of a mediator. Okay. And the quality definitely is being helpful. Do we have anything else? Oh, last one. What solution was offered by Shravan Lal and others to solve the problem?
That the shoes thing.
Yeah.
So
the problem was, first let's understand what
we'll
the problem
give
was.
You money
there
after
were already
that you
no.
Money
the problem
then...
was there right. were already a lot of people in the union. Okay?
Mm.
Already 30 people working at Connaught Circle, and one more will walk in. So you see, everybody will earn less. That's the problem. Okay?
And second problem is, he did not have that shoe.
But okay.
What solution?
So what was the solution? What are the solutions that they came up with? Shravan Lal and the people, what solution did they come
Ma'am,
up with?
Ma'am, the author, because he is educated, he can speak to English, so many people will come. So that's why they can have that solution.
Okay, so partially correct, Safiya. Because the author could speak English, they took him for corresponding with the authorities. All right? That's one solution. The reason they took him in to their union is so that he could correspond with the authorities. And the second problem was, he couldn't afford the shoe shining kit. Kit is a very good word. Okay. So what did they do?
Ma'am, they gave him
the savings. Their savings, right?
Yes.
Okay. So these are the two solutions that they came up with.
That's
all right. Now,
ma'am,
these are a few sentences. You have to take these phrases that are given in the box and put it in the correct sentence. The first one is, when Rita saw her lost puppy in her father's arms, she
jumped with joy.
Very good, Farhana. Mother didn't want me to spend the night at my friend's house, but when my friend's mother called her and assured her, she
reluctantly agreed.
Yes, she reluctantly agreed. Reluctant means to be hesitant. Okay. I am awaiting my results, but in the meantime, I have dash temporary job.
I have taken up,
that's right. My friend lent me some money and I promise to dash by the next month.
Payback
by the next month. Excellent. The old man was sitting at the same table in the coffee house since morning. Many people dash, but
had come and gone.
Very good, Munir. The security at the bank has been tightened. They are not dash anyone without ID.
Letting in.
Very good. Alright. The last part. 10:20. Okay, last part. Let's go. You have to identify the main clause and the subordinate clause. I really, really hope you remember. The main clause and the subordinate clause. Yes. Okay, let's give it a try. Astaghfirullah, you jump out of the window. Okay.
I don't have a window to jump.
Garima told her sister that her classmates were planning to visit the Lotus Temple.
Classmates were planning
main to clause.
Visit the temple.
What's the main clause? Shut up.
Garima told her sister.
Garima told her sister is the main clause. Thank you.
That her classmates were planning to visit the Lotus Temple is a subordinate clause.
Oho. Amina, I thought you did not know. That her classmates. Remember. Okay. So it's from that. Do not forget the connective over
here. Yes.
Okay, my father gave me the book which has been published by Oxford.
Gaurav will attend the meeting though he is unveiled these days.
Gaurav will attend the meeting is a main clause, and though he is unveiled these days, full marks.
Rajesh informed the visitor that the admission notice has been published in the Hindustan Times dated.
Rajesh informed the visitor.
The visitor is the main clause, and that admission notice has been published in the Hindustan Times
dated.
My friend who was coming from Mumbai has posted his visit. Has postponed his
visit. My friend is the main clause, and who was come. My friend who was coming from Mumbai is a subordinate clause.
No, who was coming from Mumbai is also a main clause. Has postponed his visit is subordinate clause.
How many of you all remember complex sentence with relative clause in the middle?
Remember, you said only to identify main and subordinate clause.
So what is relative clause? It's playing the role of a subordinate clause. Keep quiet. What's the main clause here?
My friend has postponed his visit is the main clause.
Thank you.
And the rest is a subordinate or
relative. My friend has postponed his visit is the main clause. Who was coming from Mumbai becomes your subordinate clause, or as you call it, relative clause. Hush, so much mehnat. Yogesh cannot take the final exams because he is unwell. Let's start with the debate. All teams ready? We have Muneeb, Saklan, Farana, Abdullah in one team. And we have Eminem, Safiya, Humaira, and Eminem in the other team.
Ma'am, there is no Saklan.
Oh, that's fine.
I
remember Saklan's point. His point was communication. Okay. So the topic was education system, the root cause of educated unemployment. Saklan's point was that communication is important, therefore being educated, and how would you gain this communication skills? By means of education, okay? So thus, education is not the root cause of educated unemployment. That's what Saklan meant. Okay, because if you do not have communication skills, good communication skills...
Ma'am, can you repeat the teams?
Yeah?
Can you repeat the team?
Yes, so we have Muneeb, Saklan, Farana, Abdullah, who are against the topic. They say education system is not the root cause. And we have Eminem, Safiya, Humaira, and Ahmed, who say education is the root cause. All right?
So ma'am, Saklan is not there.
Yeah, I'm there. Don't worry. Okay, let's go. So I will... Astaghfirullah, Muneeb, open your book. What was you want time? You want 2 minutes time to discuss quickly, but I'll give you only 2 minutes. I remember that. I'll call you back.
Last time you took 30 minutes and I was waiting in the room.
No, don't worry. You that will not happen. Ahmed, Dawood, Humaira,
Ma'am! I'm not Dawood. What should I do?
Go.
Father's this.
Yes, Humaira. Tell me.
Ma'am, in the last class, you're against, right?
Yeah. No. You all are four, right?
No, ma'am. Last time we wrote the...
Rule for the education.
No. So you have to say that education system is the root cause of educated unemployment. You mean education system is not that good. It has a lot of loopholes, which is leading to educated unemployment. Okay? Did you understand? Everybody. Mauza Mudabir.
Ma'am, yes, we have ma'am. Last time speech written.
Good. Okay. So see, like their point was, what was your point? Mauzam, you spoke on?
Ma'am, the technology in the colleges and
the outdated curriculum and the technology, right?
Rote learning.
Yes, only theoretical learning and rote learning. There's no practical implementation of the knowledge whatsoever. So you see, education system, because it is outdated, it is leading to educated unemployment. So y'all are for the topic. Y'all agree with the topic that yes, education system is the root cause. Okay, the other team is against the topic. They said no, education system is not the root cause. All right? And Mudabir, your point was?
My point was, ma'am, theoretical concepts and the institutions which are good are expensive.
Right. Safiya, think of something. Emma will join you in some time, okay? Chalo,
Man, loss of interest.
Loss of interest. Okay. I will call you back in a minute. Let's go. All right. Who will go first? Which team? For or against?
And we will go first.
Go ahead. The 14.
Ma'am, should I tell the whole speech again?
Yes, yes, please. It's short speech anyway.
The current Indian education system only teaches theoretical concepts and is based on a rote learning system. Thus, people are not well educated, which is leading to educated unemployment. The institutions that are good are quite expensive, so the people who are poor cannot afford to go to those institutions and have no other option than other than to go to government schools, which don't provide quality education. 70% of the Indian population live below the line of poverty, so they don't get quality education. Students don't get the chance to learn what they want to because there are many subjects which are compulsory to learn, even though they are not needed in all fields. And the government schools have employed such teachers who are not clear with their own concepts, so how are they going to teach the students?
Okay, go ahead. Everybody from the 14 will speak. And the against team has to listen. Mazam. And don't wrap out your speech like Mudabir did. please read and speak properly. I'm like, I'll just start beatboxing and it will turn out into a rap. Come on.
Ma'am, the technology used in school, in government schools and colleges is very, very old, outdated technology. And the facilities and the exam curriculum, it is only based on you learn it, you just memorize it and write it. Not just the exam, no practicals.
Rote learning, okay. That's it?
Yes.
Good. All right, Humaira, let's go. Safiya, Humaira. I think we have Safiya, Humaira, and Ahmad. Safiya, you ready? You want to go first? Go.
No, Ahmad is joining now.
No. He asked me. He took my permission. Yeah.
It's the last of interest. Because even if you don't want to learn, like if you want to become a scientist, in schools they don't have that all chemical thing. You will have to learn other subjects. Rather than becoming a scientist, you need to learn all that too. They will not give you means that you are too young to become a scientist. And then if you want to become a military person, the schools they don't give you that much like that. Kind of thing. So it's a loss of interest. They make you read, write, and it, which is not needed in like becoming a scientist.
Okay. That is Safiya's point. Like schools do not provide you a platform that will nurture your interest and your.
Can we retaliate right now or afterwards?
No. Later on. After your speeches, you have to retaliate. Alright? Humaira or Ahmad. Either one of the two, go and decide. Humaira or Ahmad. Who would like to go first? See, you need to speak. Otherwise, you will not get points. Okay? You as a team need to speak. You have to give your 30-second speech.
Can I say something?
Yes, go ahead.
The education system doesn't let you choose what subjects you want. Like most of the subjects are related to engineering, but if you want to be a linguist, they won't have the proper subjects for it.
Okay. All right. So he's saying there is no choice of subjects that the education system really provides you.
I also have another point. There's also a lack of good colleges and universities.
That's right. Okay. And Humaira, go ahead.
our education system only focuses on academic excellence and ignores the importance of being real and practical. It's minus life skills and situation management of real world.
Okay, it doesn't have life skill. It lacks that and practical knowledge. All right, excellently put. The against team, we'll start with your speeches.
May I go?
Yes, Abdullah, go ahead.
Okay, so they told that they do not have proper education system, and the students are told to study subjects when even if they don't want to study those subjects. So,
Abdullah, you are against. You are saying education.
I told this. So I will talk.
You are retaliating. I want you to speak. I want your speech. I want your opinion first.
Ma'am, can I start?
Abdullah, give me your opinion on the topic. Okay, Muneeb, go ahead. Then when it is retaliation round, we'll let Abdullah retaliate first. Okay, from here. Go ahead, Muneeb.
Ma'am, there is very much of negative influences. Ma'am, people are putting negative influences in other people's mind that you have to become this if your destiny is written like this and that. If you don't become this, you will fail and you will not be able to live like that.
Mm-hmm. Muneeb, be a little clear. Say like this, like that. We will not understand what you mean.
Ma'am, like they are saying, you have to become an engineer. If you become a doctor, your family and you will be not at a success of being a doctor. You'll have to become an engineer like that.
Okay, all right.
Ma'am, I said.
Yes.
It also is response because there is a lot of nepotism, then caste-based society, the lower caste people don't get jobs, and then you need to have interest to do a job. So there's a lot of lack of interest.
Lack of interest. Okay, that's it. You are done. Nepotism and lack of interest. All right, let's start the retaliation round. So, because the four team completed first. Okay, Abdullah, retaliation. Yeah, let's start with you against.
I tell you.
Yes, first point of retaliation.
Yes. So they told that students cannot become scientists if they're going to school because they're told to study other subjects. But that is wrong because schools have got science labs and these things. So obviously they'll be having chemicals and this stuff for the science experiments in the science lab.
Afia, that's your point.
Why don't they what if they don't allow young children wants to become the youngest scientist in the world? Why don't
obviously,
they allow the young?
It is not safe for young children to go to the science lab because they have these acid things and these stuff.
What if you want to become a military general?
Sophia, there are some chemicals that are not there because it's not safe for children. Someone might drop it on someone and then, look, parents will complain then. What do you think? Ma'am, I have
one. Sophia, you have to retaliate.
What if someone wants to become a military general? What does school have done?
No, but we are talking about scientists over here.
Oh, don't change the topic.
Okay. No, don't comment like that. Okay. Come on, Safiya. So they are saying, what was the discussion over here? Safiya's point was taken into consideration, saying that schools are equipped with science labs. Now, not necessarily Safiya has to answer it because people are retaliating to her point. Her team can help her. Okay. If you have a better response, you can retaliate. How Farhana stepped in. So you guys can also step in. Okay, it's a team thing. Also,
I don't know what
even you know this whatever is his name, this APJ Abul Kalam, he also passed this same education system, and he was a scientist.
Okay,
Ma'am, can I retaliate to Humaira's point?
Sure. Yes, so the against team will get 10 points for this.
You said that you don't have like you don't have the choice to choose subjects, right? But in NIOS, you have the choice to choose subjects, and we are studying NIOS.
Ma'am, we were talking about government education. This is not government or the government colleges. This is expensive. Not everybody can afford this, right?
See?
Right. What do you have to say to that? No retaliation. Okay, but Abdullah has the retaliation point. Yeah, go ahead.
We can choose other curriculums like IGC. We have got so many curriculums. We don't have only one curriculum.
But then speak up the point.
And ma'am, you have online courses.
Then we can choose IG curriculum, IB curriculum.
IGCSC curriculum. These are expensive. These are international curriculums. We said 70% of Indian population lives below the line of poverty. They don't have food to eat. How will they afford this? Huh?
Go ahead.
Ma'am, can I retaliate to Sakhlian's point which he said last time?
Communication. Okay, fine. Amina, are you there? Amina left. So the four team gets 10 points and it's 10 all over here. All right. Yes, retaliate to the Sakhlian.
Ma'am, Sakhlian said they should have communication skills for the jobs. So it should be taught in schools. So that's how they learn it. No, but it is not taught in schools. So they don't have the skills or the potential to communicate well.
Why is communication? So I'm Sakhlian over here. Why is the communication not taught in schools? Why do you think that is? Why do you think the subject English exists in curriculum, be it government or private, as first language or second language? That's the whole purpose of putting languages, right? For communication. Ambina, the four team will get 10 points. This is the third point of retaliation right now, and he's Mazal is retaliating to Sakhlian's point, saying that communication in schools. What was the point, Mazal? Sorry.
Communication should be taught in schools, communication skills, so that people have the potential to communicate and to speak.
All right. And I do believe that education or schools, mainstream schooling, does focus on communication, because that is like the core development that schools are dependent on. All right. So scholastic and post-scholastic, when they talk about these two aspects of school, I know Sakhlian wouldn't have been able to retaliate this way, Mazam. It's just feeling mad that I am in place. I'm a replacement for Sakhlian. But no, I'm just saying that schools do focus on communication. No? Which, name one school that doesn't focus on communication?
DWC.
Now it depends upon the students. If they are only not focusing, if they are not interested, then what is the use of the school helping them?
Right. If they, and if I have student, a retaliation point student, for Abdullah also.
If they themselves cannot...
I cannot retaliate
because it's my point, right?
Yes, ma'am, because you are so clear, ma'am.
I know. I'm shifting roles. I am Maui, a demigod. The shapeshifter. Okay. Come on, let it not die.
Now,
this is going
Muslim,
well.
Muslim told that many people are poor over there, so they cannot afford. Now it depends upon the government if they are helping the people over there.
What if they don't want to help?
Ma'am, Abdullah is speaking for the government job. So we are against the government. We are also telling that the government is not providing the facilities. And
Abdullah, you can't do that. Give them plus 5, the 4 team. Because the one from against team spoke on their behalf. Abdullah, don't do that. Think a little and then speak. Okay. Come on. Why is the debate dying? The debate shouldn't die. Think of points. Go ahead. So, Farhana mentioned about nepotism. She mentioned about, what was the second point, Farhana?
Ma'am, what is nepotism?
Reference, giving references.
Ma'am,
appointing people only through references. Yeah?
Ma'am, if you see in my area,
society.
caste-based society. Okay, that's right. We see a lot of minority schools coming up, like, you know, of certain communities, and they take admission of people only belonging to that particular community. What's your take on that?
Ma'am, as caste-based society means that they only take communities from there, right? They choose one community and they only take it from there, right?
Yes, they do that. Saying, right? Yes, that's what Farhana said.
Yeah. So, ma'am, what about the other communities? What would they do? They don't have education.
Right. So, and your point is?
So, ma'am, she's speaking for me only, no?
Again.
How?
I'm telling that if
they will be uneducated,
they take it. Yeah.
How will that lead to educated unemployment?
Matlab?
You are for the opinion that education is the root cause of educated unemployment. We are talking about educated people over here. We are not talking about uneducated people over here whatsoever.
I said opposite.
Yeah. So think before you speak. You don't want plus five to go there as well. Yes?
And you said communication skills are taught in schools, but there are some teachers in government schools who themselves don't know English and their pronunciation is sometimes ridiculous. So how are they supposed to teach the students when they themselves don't know English?
Point. Yes, Abdullah, Farhana, Munim.
They know English, but the problem is that they are look, yeah, that's okay. Of talking that type.
You cannot do that. Tumhari aadat ho gayi hai jaisa English se Hindi switch karne ki. What, Abdullah? Don't do that. All right. Humaira and Ahmed haven't spoken. Is there a point of retaliation? Muneeb, a point of retaliation for Muneeb? No.
What is Muneeb's point?
Muneeb's point, Muneeb said...
Negative influence.
Yeah, negative what? Influence.
Negative influences.
I say the negative influences is from school.
Okay, and how is that?
What did he say?
He said actually the negative influence is from the school. Ahmed said that.
So what did you say, ma'am?
No, you have to retaliate. You have to say no. Education system is not the root cause of educated unemployment. You have to say no. The school don't.
Negative influences from the school.
You agree that negative influences from the school?
No, ma'am. I'm asking how the schools are responsible for negative influences.
Of course.
So that only, no.
They don't get what they want to become.
They don't get what they want to become. They are forced to do things that they don't want
like
to do. Like, for example, Safiya said to become a scientist, it's not just science labs that you need, all right, in order to become a scientist. You need to know all these theories, these concepts. You need to apply, innovate things to make that thing work, okay? And if the child is busy doing art and craft, busy doing music, busy doing, PE is required. Busy learning Hindi, Marathi. All right, social
studies. You can choose NIOS board.
Yes,
where his
government
interest doesn't lies. Where his interest. Not everybody can afford NIOS. Again, 70% below poverty line.
Well, they should start learning about it from the child.
How? With no resources? And why are you talking? All right. Okay, so I will end it over here. I'm going to read out the scores. Let me see how far we've
gone. Ma'am, 15 to 10.
The for team has 20 and the against team has 10.
What? Against
team should get 15 points only, ma'am.
No, but against team should get 15 points.
No, ma'am. She left no in between that time.
Add 5 plus, points to 15. So still the score 15. Is 20 and 15. Okay. Four team leading. All right. Fine. Good debate. Good discussion. We'll end over here. I have a class. I have to go make ice cream. Okay. So bye-bye. See you next time.
I have a question for tomorrow. For my sister. What if we don't have blue and green? So we can make full Antarctic ice cream.
My sister's not making that's
windmill, na?
Windmill, we are making windmill tomorrow. Go buy products. Don't buy recycled.
What windmill, ma'am?
But for LED fan, though, we have to buy only,
no? LED light, yes.
Light is.
LED light and mini fan. LED light. Okay, chalo bye.
Bye, ma'am.